Ah, there goes my buzz. There goes my buzz, man. Yep, and I see an ad playing on my window.
And the chat is talking about it. And about your wrist.
I have a buzzy wrist. Known as an Apple Watch. I actually also ordered myself a new MacBook Pro. I know that the internet at large is very disappointed with the new MacBook Pro, but my MacBook Pro is like 5 years old, so I was waiting for the new update to get the upgrade, and I've done it. So hopefully I will have that sometime before the end of the year, and I'll know if the Touch Bar is all that and a bag of chips or just a gimmick.
So now you've had Apple Watch for a year or more. How is it?
Yeah, I like
it. Like after that long term.
Yeah, I don't know that I would say I love it, but it fills a need in my life that I did not know that I had, and now I'm thrilled to have it. Like on occasion I'll like not wear it for like a day, or you know, like one thing that's actually been happening a lot is like when I go out with my wife on date night, I wear this watch, like a nice like heirloom watch. That's the way to say it. That my father left me.
That's a classy word.
Yeah, like it's an heirloom. It's now a family heirloom that my dad left to me, and so I wear that watch, and when I do. I feel a little bit naked because when I get a message on my phone, my wrist doesn't buzz and I go to look at it and I'm like, oh wait, that's not what I was expecting. So yeah, I mean, I like it. Is it, I'm not going to be like, unlike with the phones where I try to upgrade as quickly as I can to whatever get the new hotness. I won't be doing that with the watch. Although I do think, spoiler alert, don't tell anyone. I think I might be getting my wife one for Christmas because
I can think about now is when we were numb. Your father gave me his watch, and I kept that watch.
And we'll leave out where that story leads. All right, so, hey everybody. So, did anything happen since our stream last week? I feel like it was a completely empty week. Absolutely nothing happened since we signed off last week.
Yeah. Nothing at all.
No world news, no American political news, nothing. It was like the entire week just dropped off.
Into a void.
Or maybe that's just my selective memory. I actually had a conversation with the team today about how much we were going to sort of talk about this, and I did just want to say this. Whether you are happy about Trump winning or unhappy about Trump winning, and I do understand that a lot of you aren't even in America, so you may not even have an opinion about this. Irrespective of any of that, the ridiculousness that has happened since he won is, to my mind and to our mind, completely unacceptable. The way that people are being treated in this country right now is abhorrent to us. And I think you know that because, you know, we actually have added it to our script that, you know, that we believe in being inclusive. And frankly, there's a lot of people in this country not being inclusive right now. And that is a real bummer. There's a lot of marginalized communities out there that are going to need your help and support in the coming years as we move into the next wave of American history. So I hope that you will, you know, we will hopefully put forth our best foot and be a force for good in this world, and we hope that you will join us. And I think that's all we're going to say about that. We're just going to start to play some games, and, you know, it's a cooperative game. That's what we make. We make cooperative games. And so... in the spirit of that, let's be cooperative tonight and have a good time. So yeah, it's Tuesday. It's 7-ish. So that must mean it's time to welcome you all to Sentinels Live. Thanks, as always, for joining us around the digital tabletop while we play Sentinels of the Multiverse. The goal of these streams, of course, is to have some fun while showing you how to play the game, as well as covering some strategies that could help you win. At Handelabra, we do believe, as I just mentioned, in being as inclusive as possible. So comments, activity, etc., actively working against that goal is not welcome and will not be tolerated. If you like the show, please like, share, follow, and subscribe. And of course, as we are the developers, you can always be sure to get some insight into the process and maybe, just maybe, see something before anyone else. Spoiler alert, you're going to get to see something tonight. The game does include a tutorial that covers the basics, but we always do our best to explain exactly what we're doing, when we do it, and why. And depending on how long it takes for us to win or lose, we often play more than one full game in an episode. And episodes are somewhere between 1 and 2 hours. Sentinels of the Multiverse is currently available for iOS, Android, as well as PC, Mac, and Linux via Steam, and always via good old analog cardboard and ink. And you can get more info about the game at sentinelsdigital.com. All right.
Good spiel.
Good spiel. So, as I mentioned, we are going to show you something new tonight. I think we're going to show you something new. But before we do that, you see on my screen here this a new team emerges, the Prime Wardens. Have you
That's
guys
something new that happened since last stream?
That is something new that's happened since last stream. So, who out there has unlocked one or more of the Prime Wardens? We know for a fact that a number of people have unlocked Argent Adept. At least one person has unlocked Tempest as well as Captain Cosmic. To our understanding, no one has yet unlocked Haka or Fnatic.
Well, the conditions have been discovered for Tempest as well.
Oh, have the conditions been discovered?
Yeah.
I did not
You've
know
been
that.
Busy this week.
Yes.
But that happened.
All right. Well, we'll make sure
and they're pretty close on Captain Cosmic. I think they just had to tie all the threads together. Mm. But yeah, no Haka, no Fnatic. So keep looking for them.
Yes, indeed. They are definitely out there. And, yeah, as somebody just said something about being a playtester, yes. Sanvar, I also, this was one of the times where, one of the things I really like about the testing the variant unlocks is that they help you maybe explore the game in ways that you might not typically play. I know that, at least for me, I can't speak for anybody else out there, but I tend to be one of those players that's like, I find my grooves with specific characters, and then I just play that way. You know, obviously playing on the stream, especially with John helping me out on strategy, I'm always learning new ways to figure it out. But I really like, and again, this is probably a little bit unfair because I go into it saying, all right, here's the unlock condition. How can I do that? And so that's a little bit different than you guys trying to figure out what the unlock condition is by throwing everything against the wall and seeing what sticks. But I do enjoy sort of playing the game differently to try and sort of uncover some of that stuff. So I see we've got someone said that they were the one to unlock Captain Cosmic first. Da266. So are you the one who actually got the Hall of Fame? I don't remember. I don't know that. I don't recognize that username, but maybe you have a different Twitter name. But anyway, so yeah, so keep at it. You know, we're as you guys know, 30 days after we'll put the button in, so you'll be able to play with them either way, even if you can't figure it out on your own.
Yeah, you can actually play with them right now on the weekly one shot, the ones you don't have unlocked.
Actually, I'll pull that up so you guys can see. Yes, so Make It to Go, the weekly one shot this week has the Prime Wardens in there, so you can get a preview of what it is that you've got going on there.
And warning, it's not an easy game.
All right. So, I'm going to open up a new online game here. We got Mystery Comics number 9. And as I think I just mentioned, I think we're going to show you something new this week. What's this big white/tan box that's up there?
Should ask the stream if we should push it.
Should we push?
We should get a vote on whether we should push it or not.
Yes. Do I push the white box? Push the button. It's white. When I mouse over it, it becomes tan. Do I push that button? If we can get at least 3 yes votes, then I'll push it.
I don't know if they'll say yes. I'll answer a question while we're waiting. There was a question about adding new achievements. We are not planning to add more achievements right now because we have a limit of 100, and Greater Than Games has made too many variants. So, potentially in the future, but not right now.
So, these guys don't realize that they actually almost didn't have us push it. Because it was like, push it, then push it, don't do it, and no. If a third vote had come in, oh boy. So, we'll push it. Zoink! What is that? So, this, I'm going to push it again so you can see that cool animation. So, zoink and zoink. Welcome to Team Villain Mode. That's right. As you guys know, Vengeance dispenses with the usual big bad versus a team of heroes and instead allows you to take on a team of heroes a team of villains with a team of heroes. And that's right, folks. We're going to give you your first look at Vengeance style/villain team gameplay right here tonight on the stream. Tweet your friends, let them know to come check it out.
Yep. We've been working hard on this for quite a while now, and we're looking forward to showing it off.
Yeah, and as you guys know, because we discussed it, there were a lot of really interesting UI challenges. You know, Sentinels already has a lot to be on the screen, and when you take the villain and multiply it by 5, that certainly doesn't get any easier. So I think what we're going to do tonight, and again, John, tell me if you agree or disagree. I figured we would do our usual 4-player game where I do 2, you do 2, and we do 4 of the villains. And then as we're playing, we'll sort of talk through some of the UI decisions that we made and why.
Sure. Yeah, especially because some of the things are going to be different than the mock-ups we showed in the Kickstarter.
Exactly. Okay, so the 5 villains, we'll actually let the chat choose who were not, which of the 5 villains we will not play tonight. So the choices are Baron Blade, Ermine, Friction, Fright Train, and Proletariat. They are the nemeses of, I believe, Legacy, the Wraith, Tachyon, Bunker, and Absolute Zero. So the first
one... You can double-click on them and see.
Too. Yeah, that's actually what I did.
Okay.
Because I was realizing as I got into it that I was like, I'm pretty sure Burnblade is still Legacy, but I want to make sure. So, all right. Yeah, so... I guess we've got 4 votes for no Fright Train. My vote would have been for no Ermine, but I guess...
That's what I was thinking you were hoping.
That was what I was hoping for. All right, yeah, in all my testing, I found that Ermine is probably my least favorite at this point. Okay. So, we're going to play a game against Baron Blade, Ermine, Friction, and Proletariat. So, let's pop these Vengeance villains open and see what they look like. So, first of all, you'll notice that these cards are different than regular villain character cards. They're sort of landscape. They've got the character on one side, all of their text on the other side. When they flip over, they become incapacitated. It's not like single player or single villains where they have 2 different sides with different mechanics. These guys actually get incapacitated in the same way, guys and gals, get incapacitated in the same way the heroes get incapacitated. But instead of having 3 choices for an incap power, they just have 1. Let's take a look at how these play a little bit differently, and then we'll sort of pick our team, and then we'll go. So Baron Blade, the start of the game, Baron Blade enters play, evolved madman side up, genetically fused psyche is put into play, cards are revealed from the top. What did I say?
Genetically fused psyche, which is a totally different thing.
Genetically fused psyche, excuse me. Cards are revealed from the top of the villain deck until a device is revealed and put into play. Other revealed cards are returned to the villain deck, which is shuffled. Gameplay. At the end of Baron Blade's villain turn, Baron Blade deals the hero target with the lowest HP and himself 2 melee damage. Reduce damage dealt to device cards by 2. And that card that he plays also heals him up when he takes damage. So that's no fun. Ermine. At the start of the game, Ermine enters play Con Artist Extraordinaire side up. Constant Prattle is put into play. This card discards the top card of every deck at the end of her turn, I believe. At the end of Ermine's turn, the top card of Ermine's villain deck is revealed. If it is a one-shot, put it into play. If it is not, it is discarded, and Ermine deals the hero target with the second lowest HP 2 melee damage. At the start of Ermine's turn, destroy 1 hero ongoing. Oh, that's advanced. So we'll skip that. We're definitely not playing advanced today. Friction. So what's cool about Friction, being that she is Tachyon's nemesis, is that a lot of the mechanics that you're used to on Friction, on Tachyon as a hero, you're now going to get to see the flip side of that as a villain, which is really pretty cool, actually. At the start of the game, Friction enters play shockingly speedy side up. Shock dampeners and stolen gear put into play. The villain deck is shuffled. Gameplay, at the end of Friction's turn, Friction deals the hero target with the highest HP 1 melee damage. And finally, we have Proletariat. At the start of the game, Proletariat enters play the Everyman side up. 2 cards named Proletariat are put into play. The villain deck is shuffled. Whenever this card would be dealt non-psychic damage, redirect that damage to the clone card with the lowest HP. At the end of Proletariat's turn, this card deals the hero target with the highest HP 2 melee damage. So you guys might be used to Proletariat if you're big Sentinels fans. Aside from playing Proletariat in Sentinels of the Multiverse, you've also probably played Proletariat in Sentinel Tactics, which is... that's where you can really see how, like, he hits himself and then another clone appears and et cetera, et cetera. So, okay, so it looks like John has already chosen Legacy and Tachyon. So I guess that means I'm playing the Wraith and Absolute Zero. I saw in the chat people were saying, play the nemesis. Play the nemesis. All right, so the question is,
The villains actually have other mechanical relationships with their nemesis. Like, Ermine is all about destroying stuff, whereas Wraith is all about putting stuff into play, mm-hmm. equipment and so on. And Baron Blade works like a legacy for his team.
Aha. All right, so yeah, I'm going to flip. There's been a quest to see the in-cap side. So here's Baron Blade's in-cap side. At the start of Baron Blade's villain turn, each hero target deals itself one toxic damage. Ermine's in-cap. At the start of Ermine's turn, discard the top two cards of each hero deck. Friction. At the start of Friction's turn, destroy one hero ongoing or equipment card. And then Proletariat. At the start of Proletariat's turn, shuffle the hero trash with the most cards into its associated deck. A real super bummer for Tachyon. All right, and then I need a Wraith. The question is, which Wraith do I want? Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, so Sockfoot was asking to explain the new rules for team play, so I'll do that while Jeremy is deciding. So with regular Sentinels, as you know, you have a villain, and then all the heroes go in order, and then the environment. With team mode, the turns alternate. So Baron Blade's going to go first, then Legacy, then Ermine, then the Wraith, then Friction, then Tachyon, then Proletariat, then Absolute Zero, then the environment. So you actually will have four villain turns and four hero turns interspersed, and the environment turn at the end, and then it loops back around.
Sorry, go ahead.
Sometimes there are cards that refer to things like the villain deck and or the villain turn, and those change a little bit in Vengeance to typically you'll choose a villain deck, but sometimes it'll do all the villain decks, depending on what it is. Mm-hmm. So.
All right, so we just need an environment. Did you have an opinion about that, John? I feel like we should do something that's a little bit less crazy for our first showing of Vengeance mode. And actually, as I scroll before, I'll go ahead and say this before everybody calls me out on it. Yes, you'll notice that Freedom Tower and Mobile Defense Platform are in here. They are still in testing. We will not be showing those off this evening.
Tonight, everything is in testing.
Everything is in testing,
for
yes.
example, Jeremy, do not play Sub-Zero Atmosphere.
Fair enough. It is unlikely that that is a card I would have played anyway.
But if you do, it is bad. Yeah, we could play in, like, maybe the block. Mm. Is there any particular environment you want to see some of the new graphics?
Oh, right.
Gulch, maybe.
I'll tell you, I actually had a really good game in Final Wasteland playing Vengeance. Because one of the things that happens in Vengeance is not only are you playing against multiple villains, but they each have multiple targets. And I found a scenario with the Final Wasteland where I got Unforgiving Wasteland out, and that was really helping because it was getting some of their targets out of play. I actually got a couple of the villains out of play so that I didn't have to worry about their in-cap sides. So that would be a fun one, I think.
Sure.
All right, let's try that. Boom. All right, so
and all good.
So yeah, we've got everybody matched up with their nemesis in terms of the order. Not that that necessarily matters, but that's the way we've got it set up. So we got Baron Blade, Legacy, Ermine, Wraith, Friction, Tachyon, Proletariat, and Absolute Zero. Team villain mode at Final Wasteland. Here we go. All right, so the first thing you'll notice is the new opening screen. FPO Young Legacy, FPO Baron Blade.
FPO times two.
Yeah, so that hasn't been written yet, but you'll notice that we've got, the sort of team leader, which is the person in the first position, is nice and big, and then we've got the rest of his team sort of next to him here. And we've got our illustrious heroes along the bottom, as always. So, I already read off what's going to happen when I click this. I'm sure people missed it, but I'll try and talk through it as it comes into play. But let's do what we usually do. Young Legacy starts with Flying Smash, Fortitude, Motivational Charge, and Thok. The Wraith, I actually chose Freedom 6 Wraith, Price of Freedom. Grappling Hook, Omega Computer, Trust Fund, Utility Belt. Team Leader Tachyon has got a Blinding Speed, Light Speed Barrage, Quick Insight, and Sonic Vortex, and... Elemental Wrath, aka Freedom 6 Absolute Zero, has got a modular realignment, null point calibration, onboard modular insulation, and thermal shockwave. That's a great start. I'm very excited. All right.
So at the start of the game, all the villains do their start of the game things, starting with the first villain.
Leo9981 asks, how does the phone version look so far? No comment. It's coming along. It's not as far along as this version, which is why we're showing off this version. But yeah, as it stands now, every time we release anything, it will be released across all versions simultaneously. So that is also under construction as we speak. Yes, people are asking, what does FPO mean? FPO stands for for placement only. It is a graphic design term.
Yeah. We'll probably do a phone version stream vengeance mode at some point.
Definitely. Yeah, we're going to want to show that off. All right, so start game. So out comes genetically fused Psyche, and then as you remember,
Psyche. Psyche is the thing that it's not.
Physique. Genetically fused physique. It's the Q is tripping me up. And then he searches for a device.
Psyche,
he gets impulsion.
Have a Q.
I understand that, but Psyche. I don't know. Whatever. And now you've tripped me up, so now I'm not reading off what's happening as it's happening.
Everything is happening.
All the things are happening. Okay, so. Hang on. All right. All the things.
He played a card that's making all of them play a card.
So many cards. So many plays. And vengeance mode, you usually lose in the first turn. And there you go. Another proletariat comes out. Another proletariat comes out. My goodness. All right, so stolen gear, proletariat, healing up, maximum HP. Wah-wah.
Yeah, so old tricks, new allies, heals all the villains, but they're all full.
Okay, so before you do anything, let's go back and this is good because it flipped us so we can take a look at this. So when Baron Blade played his card, he started with genetically fused physique.
Yay.
And then he searched for a device, brought out impulsion beam. Ermine. And actually, so you guys, I'll go ahead and talk through this real quick. So you'll notice we've got all of our villains down here in the bottom right-hand corner. And then we've got this big sort of combined villain area. Because as the hero team, you're going to want to see what's in play, everything that's in play at any given time. But there's a distinct possibility that you'll want to see a specific character's card. So all you have to do is click on that character and it'll filter that area by just that particular villain. So you'll notice that Baron Blade here has genetically fused psychology and impulsion beam in play. Ermine has got constant prattle. Friction has her shock dampeners, which makes her immune to lightning damage. Stolen Gear, which has her play the top card of her deck at the end of her turn. And Revenant, which is another target that increases damage by the villain target with the highest HP by one. I'll pop that open again. So that's a Nemesis card. That is a new, interesting mechanic that's in the sort of team villain mode, which is that it has an effect, and then it has another effect based on what heroes are in the game. So this one says, if Setback is active in this game, increase damage dealt by villain targets by one. Luckily, Setback is not in this game. And then we've got Proletariat, who has four Proletariat clones in play. So there you go. All right, is there more we want to talk about this for the moment, or should we go ahead and start wailing on the villains?
One thing that's important to note is that Impulsion Beam prevents you from playing more than one hero card a turn and using more than one power per turn.
Yes. Tachyon
so that card,
really doesn't like that.
Or the Wraith.
Yeah, well, yes, true.
Or anyone, really. Mm-hmm. I mean, some heroes don't mind, but it actually ends up affecting a lot of heroes because, you know, something like you play Impromptu Invention. Well, that's your play. You don't get to play another card after, for instance.
Yeah, so the chat was one step ahead of us, it seems, and I answered their question as they were preparing to answer it. So, yes. I find that I actually bounce back and forth between the two views quite a bit, actually. I like being able to see everything, especially when it comes to things like ongoings and stuff like that. I want to see everything that's in play all in one go. But then if I'm like, okay, if I'm going to focus on someone, I want to see exactly what's happening with them. And so I'll pop that open.
Yeah. And the idea for this, it's sort of like that villain's thought bubble, if you think of when you click on a hero. Mm-hmm. But when you're playing the game as heroes, it's a different perspective than the villain. So we didn't want it to be a thought bubble for the villain in the same way.
Yeah, you don't get to see inside the villain's mind in the same way.
And you can access their deck and trash by clicking on them from the screen at all times.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's what you can see down at the bottom here. We've got the deck. Here's Baron Blade's trash. Old trick, new allies came out. One shot, play the top card of each villain deck and turn order other than Baron Blades. Each villain target regains 1 HP, so that was why, as I hit start, it was like, all the things are happening. So that was that card that had come out. And we can do that for all the others. So you'll notice, like, Proletariat's got a share in the struggle in his trash, and Ermine has got Heavy Hitter.
Yeah, I've definitely played more Vengeance games in the last couple weeks than in my life testing, because it is tricky to get it to the table because it's complicated to set up.
Yeah, and that was absolutely one of our design goals was, you know, we know that, you know, one of the main complaints about Sentinels on the tabletop, whether you agree with this complaint or not, is that it can be somewhat fiddly. And Vengeance sort of multiplies that to, by five, because there's five villains to keep track of. And so we really wanted to try and, you know, make it as simple to play as the regular game when you're playing it digitally.
All right, so I'm using a Flying Smash to knock some sense into these characters. And I think, who are you thinking of focusing on? If we're going to focus on someone. Proletariat has a lot of clones out, so
yeah, he's
right
going to be tough. I mean, I deeply dislike Ermine with the passion of a thousand fiery suns. So,
all right. Ermine's not too bad in capability as well. So,
yeah, exactly. I mean, you know, if you have someone in play like, Night Mist and she's trying to stack the top of her deck, or, you know, other kinds of characters who have good deck manipulation, she can be frustrating because on her incap, I believe she discards the top card of every deck, right?
Tachyon
top
likes
two
that,
cards
though.
Of every deck. Yeah, Tachyon doesn't mind that. Unless, of course, Proletariat is also incapped and making her shuffle her trash.
Yeah.
Okay. So, another bit that you guys might notice from this, and it may go unnoticed because you guys are taking in a lot of information. I'm going to, meanwhile, real quick, you'll notice that there's a solid color bar underneath either one of the heroes or one of the villains, depending on whose turn it is, and that is telling you who is up next. We added that after we got this right into, we played it, we got the UI built, and we started playing it a few times, and we realized it's probably really important to get a feel for where you are in the turn order. Because as John was explaining earlier, it goes hero, or it goes villain, hero, villain, hero, villain, hero, environment. And so it's pretty easy to get lost if you're not paying close attention. So we added that solid color bar so you know who's coming next. So in this case, you can see that the next hero turn is the Wraith. And we are on Ermine's turn right now.
Yep.
She has played Sleight of Hand. One player must put a card from hand on top of their deck, and then Ermine deals each target one projectile damage. So let's see what we got here.
And she's going to discard that. At the end of her turn, she discards the top card.
Exactly. So whatever card you put on the top of your deck.
Constant Prattle does that. But
right, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, so any card that you put to the top of your deck, you're basically banishing to your trash.
Yeah. Generally, I'm okay with Tachyon doing that unless someone else has something they'd rather.
Well, I was going to... So, I have my null point calibration unit and I have modular realignment. But...
Sure.
So I was going to say, like, I could just trash that onboard modular installation this turn and then use modular realignment to get my null point back next turn. So...
You mean you want to trash the null point, not your onboard module installation?
Right, yeah. I'm going to play onboard module installation this turn to get my thermal, the other one, and then I'll be able to play this one with my module realignment, and I'll be all set up, hopefully.
So you can see when the villains are dealing damage or in dialogues and stuff, we show a sort of normal villain card for them. That's more to make it fit in the screen properly. But when you can double click on that to bring up the full card with all the text as well.
All right, so I have a grappling hook. Do we want to get rid of that genetically fused psychology, psychedelia? Or...
Yeah, I think you should destroy genetically fused pastiche.
Yes, I concur. All right. I mean, I hate Ermine, so I would want to get rid of her ongoings just out of spite purely. But I think in this case, getting rid of the Psycor is a better choice. And let's do some damage. I'm gonna keep piddling down on that impulsion beam, because that is really annoying. And then, let's see, one more damage. If I hit Proletariat, that's going to go to one of his clones. Oh, Nemesis bonus against Ermine. Say no more.
Double up the damage.
Genetically fused pastiche. That's definitely the winner so far. All right, so Supersonic Streak comes out. You'll notice there's another keyword on that, and that is Surge. Friction's Surge cards are the sort of villainous equivalent to Tachyon's Burst cards. So she has a number of cards in her deck that are do X based on the number of Surge cards in your trash, for instance.
Oh, very quiet turn for Friction there. She
yes,
didn't have.
Yeah, I was kind of.
Didn't have any cards in her trash. Many cards in her trash. Or we didn't have much for her to destroy as well.
Yeah, let's pull that up actually real quick. So she got Supersonic Streak. Friction deals herself and the X hero targets with the highest HP 2 lightning damage each, where X is the number of Surge cards in her trash. So not much happened there because I think that was the first one, so she had none. And then the next one that she played from her. Whatever her thing in play that lets her play another card was Surge Strike. Friction deals herself one lightning damage, and Friction deals the hero target with the highest HP X melee, where X is the number of Surge cards in her trash. And so that's the other thing I did want to mention, is that her shock dampeners, story time. Friction, being Tachyon's nemesis, she gets her speed from this suit that she wears, and it is shocking her unless she has her shock dampeners in play. If you can get rid of her shock dampeners, using her suit damages her with lightning damage. But you gotta obviously get that out of play first. So much cool, fun story stuff.
So, Jeremy, your master plan was to play onboard module installation?
It had been.
And then not play the card from it because of impulsion beam?
Oh, shoot. Yeah, I can, you know what? I can modular realignment just right away.
Okay.
Unless you're
going
to kill that.
Do quick insight. I would have to use my Sonic Vortex, and I feel like that's a waste at this point.
Understood.
And maybe I'll get you something else to play.
Stunbolt. Strike. Another onboard module installation. Yeah, so one thing you'll notice when you start playing team villain mode is that it really messes with your rhythm. Because you get used to this idea of, like, the villain's going to do a thing, and then we get four turns of, like, setting up and preparing and hitting and doing and thinging and whatever.
And our prototype has all of his clones.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, and that is just not the way that it works. When you are playing team villain mode, it's every time a hero does something, the villain comes back and does something again right away. So,
yeah, this is gonna hurt. Got 2 damage to the highest 6 times.
Yeah, I mean, the one potential upside for Proletariat, which I don't know if we've discussed this yet, but his clones actually damage him at the beginning of the turn. But he has sort of an escape route for that, which is that he has a card in his deck called... Where is it? What's the one that he does that kills all his clones and then heals them up? Regroup and Recover. Destroy all clone cards. Proletariat regains 3 HP for each card destroyed. This way, play the top card of Proletariat's deck. So yeah, that one is frustrating. Okay, yeah, let's modular realignment. We'll get my null point out. Damage myself for 1 and heal back up for 1, and then I'm kind of set up and I can deal some damage. All right.
You can take out the impulsion beam.
Yeah, I was
going to
say, I'm going to get rid of that impulsion beam because that is harshing my mellow. Bellasaur Sierra says, I have a dilemma. I need food, but I don't want to miss the witty banter.
Oh, the skunk ape was going to destroy it anyways.
Wah wah.
All right, I don't think the order's going to matter, so.
Yeah.
Punch, 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 punch. Choose which proletariat is the lowest. doesn't matter at this point.
That was where my mouse was closest because I was holding on the fast forward button. So, ugh, negation bands, another one I really deeply dislike.
Well, if you're not really targeting Baron Blade, it's not a big deal.
That's true.
Ugh.
Yeah, so one thing that John told me about, because I played a few sort of, Vengeance games, sort of not really thinking ahead and just sort of, you know, seeing how it goes. And he said a really good strategy with Vengeance-style villains is sort of focus damage one villain and get them out and then focus damage on another one. But another piece of strategy that he told me is anyone who can do area damage is super useful. So, you know, Tachyon obviously has a number of cards that can do like one damage broadly, and if you can get a boost on it, that's great. Hypersonic Assault can basically neuter the other team if you can manage to get that to hit everybody. And so, yeah, it definitely changes your strategy because, you know, something like a Hypersonic Assault is useful in, you know, environments that have a lot of damage-dealing targets or a villain that has a lot of minions. But in this case, against major villains, it actually is super useful because it means that you can essentially get a whole round, without having to worry about too much damage, which is nice. And Long Con comes out. Each player discards one card, and Ermine gains back some hit points, or HP, as it were.
That's a thing she does. Yeah, one thing that does often happen in Vengeance games is that there are a lot of ongoing cards in play. Mm-hmm. And when I have Ra on the team, I usually happily allow all of those ongoing cards to remain in play because I can do more damage.
Yes. Was it Drawn to the Flame?
It's kind of crazy. Drawn to the Flame, you can be doing like 6 damage to all villain targets. Maybe twice, because there's 2 copies and you can use Flame Spike.
Yes, yes.
It's kind of crazy.
All right. Who's dealing us the most damage right now?
I don't know. Proletariat?
Yeah,
but you won't
be
able to hit him.
But I can't hit him. All right, maybe instead... Yeah, I can do a little bit of damage.
I'm going to try to look for a Hypersonic Assault, but...
Yeah, I'm not set up the way I want, so I'm going to Trust Fund. Okay, throwing knives, that'll work. All right, good. So I can get rid of one of those stun bolts. And I'm definitely not going to inventory barrage anytime soon, so let's do that. And then I'll hopefully start to get those throwing knives and maybe my micro-targeting computer out if we can. So let's see. Yeah, so John's voting for Ermine. That's always a good choice with the Nemesis damage, so that's good. And then... What do you think? Shock dampeners?
Sure.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can get her to kill herself in one shot.
Yes. Yeah. With her surge cards, that is a very real possibility. Blinding Surge. Destroy X hero ongoings. Wah, wah.
My motive might feel unmotivated.
Yeah. And that's the other thing, again, about Vengeance style or team villain mode. Getting set up is not as easy.
Yeah. At least this set of villains destroying a lot of stuff.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Ooh, Inspiring Presence.
Nice. I get another Mega Computer, Supersonic Response, Coolant Blast.
Six burst cards in my trash, eh? Let's get more. Not really concerned about constant prattle or speedy sidestep, so I'm going to play Supersonic Response, I think. And I can get a double hit on Friction, so I'm going to do that with Nemesis bonus.
Yeah, so Bella Sorcier says, now I'm impatient for villains of the multiverse. That is true. You know, like, especially in testing now, I have now played against these five villains in various configurations of three, four, and five villains many, many times. But remember, Vengeance doesn't just come with the villain team mode. It also comes with five new heroes, one of which you've already seen if you have the season pass in Setback. But there's lots of new heroes and two new environments on top of a whole new gameplay mode. This is definitely the biggest expansion we have. It's the biggest project we've done since launching the core game. Well, multiplayer may qualify, but it's harder to quantify that because it wasn't Dex. It was
the biggest content project.
It's the biggest content project, like, hands down, for sure.
Chipping away at some of these proletariats.
I'm Parse, Knife, the Sentinels. Yes, indeed.
The Naturalist.
Very good stuff. And of course, and since we've already mentioned it, the two environments, of course, are Mobile Defense Platform and the Freedom Tower. Freedom Tower, of course, being the home of the Freedom 5, which is within Megalopolis, and the Mobile Defense Platform is Baron Blade's sort of base of operations.
Proletariat, don't beat yourself up, man.
Cytosine says, I realize this isn't quite done yet, but I would not have expected a Vengeance preview tonight. Well, we aim to please. We like to show you guys here on the stream stuff as soon as we consider it to be showable. You know, it's definitely not done, and there's a good chance that there may be some bugs, but we know that you guys come here because you're huge fans of Sentinels, just like we are. And so we like being able to show stuff, even if it's not quite ready. I will tell you, though, are you guys checking out this new artwork from Adam? What? So cool.
Yeah, the villain artwork is really cool. And, we hope to be showing you some heroes soon, too. Not this week, but...
Yeah.
All right, now you can onboard away.
All right, so let's hit that up. Draw a cryo chamber. I'm going to put my isothermic transducer out. Or at least I'm going to get it. Yeah, I think I'm going to put it out, too.
Why don't you play the other onboard module installation?
Oh, yeah, that's a good call. Why didn't I do that? Because I wasn't paying attention. All right, so we'll grab that. And then onboard module again. Draw null point, so I'll take the other isothermic. All right. And actually, I'm glad that I did that. Let's see. Frostbound drain. Yeah, I need to get that out if I'm going to do the frostbound drain. So, yeah, I'll just get that out. Excuse me. The amount of fire damage has been dealt. Okay, so... Oh, Everyman's Strength came out? Oof. Oh, no, actually, that's better when he has more. I forgot. All right, so let's...
Yeah, when he has... No clones, it gives him like plus 6 damage.
Yeah.
I would keep hitting it, Ermine.
That is a solution that I will almost never disagree with. Yeah, Ermine has gone to number one with a bullet on my list of like least favorite team villains. It's her ongoing destruction, and it's so frustrating. She gets in my way, and she annoys me.
See, look, these skunk apes are taking care of everything for us. All right, order matters. So.
Yeah, so let's kill that... 1 HP proletariat.
Yeah, because he'll redirect from himself to the lowest, so we can orchestrate the destruction of a couple proletariats here. We just need to vote for this other proletariat, and then we can choose for me.
Alright, we don't need to hit the shock dampeners first or anything?
Nope.
Alright.
I mean, it doesn't protect against melee damage.
Got it.
I can take out that every man's strength before proletariat goes as well.
Okay, cool.
I don't think order's gonna matter here either.
Pow, 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 pow.
A lot of targets. And here's Baron Blade again. Ugh, regression darts. Who's gonna get these? The two.
Oh, my! One of my least favorite Baron Blade cards. Legacy and Tachyon. Oh, bummers.
Yeah. And it's plus one from Revenant. So they are throat jabbed.
Yep.
And Baron Blade goes after the lowest. Pretty rough.
Yeah, and then he hits himself, and those negation bands let him heal up, which is super annoying.
Well, yes. Even though I can't deal damage, Inspiring Presence is happening.
None left to ask, will Vengeance Mode allow 1v1 or 2v2? It will not.
Nope, the minimum number of heroes is 3.
Yep. Yeah, 3, 4, and 5 are the supported configurations. Oh, Ermine.
Probably Tachyon.
Yeah, card from hand.
Yeah, she can't deal damage, so may as well discard Accelerated Assault.
Yeah, see, this is why I deeply dislike her, right? She, like, takes cards out of play. She takes cards out of hand. She makes you discard. No fun.
If I could deal damage, I could do a pretty sweet lightspeed barrage.
So John has already told me I can't play Sub-Zero Atmosphere. I'll just discard that.
I mean, you can, but it will die very quickly.
Okay.
It causes all villain effects to happen at the start of every villain turn.
Oh, I see.
All villains on every turn. Not good.
That's like super advanced double challenge mode.
Yeah. I don't think anyone's up for that.
Yeah. All right. So, yeah, let's try and get myself set up here. So we'll get throwing knives out. And let's see here. All right, Inspiring Presence. Good times.
Yeah, I would hit Ermine for sure.
Yeah, so definitely hit Ermine for 3. And then we could get rid of the negation bands and one of the proletariats.
Sure.
Yeah, that's what I would do. So that's what I'm going to do. Boom, boom, and boom. And inventory barrage. And friction. Unhealthy speed. 1 melee damage, deals yourself 1 lightning damage. And play the top card, and then play the top card. Thanks to stolen gear.
Hey, she hits herself now.
She does hit herself because we got rid of the shock dampener, so that's good.
But she is putting a lot of surges in her trash.
Oh my goodness. All right, so she's only at 6, so I think we shift gears from hitting Ermine and we try to get friction out of there. So Tachyon cannot deal damage.
You probably should have a thing that says how many surge cards are in her trash. It seems like it's probably a lot. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, and she has a card. Does she have? I thought she had a card that deals more damage based on surges. Maybe she already discarded it or something. Well, I can't deal damage, so I'm going to destroy an ongoing card. Probably Everyman's Strength.
Yeah, that would be my choice.
I'm not going to play Lightspeed Barrage when I cannot deal damage, so I'm a real fan of Fnatic.
Yep. And there's the Hypersonic Assault.
If I survive to play it.
Yeah, so here's Proletariat. Each of his clones damage him. So this is where someone like the Visionary comes into play. The only kind of damage that doesn't get redirected when he has clones out is psychic damage. So if you can make yourself do psychic damage or make other people do psychic damage, you can take him out even if he has clones in play.
All right, we should choose the character card first so that he can hit the Wraith, and then one of the non-nemeses can hit Absolute Zero. Who wants to take damage? Wraith, I guess?
Yeah, Wraith can take it.
Oh.
Yeah, so since I'm playing Freedom 6 Absolute Zero, unfortunately I can't use this, my cold damage here to heal myself because it explicitly says Absolute Zero deals one non-hero target two cold damage. But I could...
You couldn't press Grand Drain, but you don't have any bonuses, so it's not going to help you.
Yeah, that's what, like, if I already had Focus Apertures out, that would be useful.
I would play Focus Apertures.
Yeah, that's probably what I'm going to do.
And hope you survive. One of us is most likely going down due to Baron Blade on his turn.
So what do you think? Three against friction?
Sure. Yeah. The environment will probably take her out.
Yeah.
There's pretty good odds on that. So we're down to one just from the apes. Ooh. All right, we can remove a proletariat clone from the game.
Nice.
I don't think the order is going to matter here. So you can choose for me. Of course, we are almost going to get removed from the game as well.
That is true.
So yeah, so choose that one hit point proletariat. Actually, we'll remove both of them from the game.
Yeah.
Because the other one's going to redirect.
Yep.
It's interesting.
All right, so two proletariats gone.
And we are all at two or three hit.
It's fine. Everything's fine. A chance at vengeance. Ugh. Uh-oh. You disconnected. Oh, and you're back. You still there? Yeah, John's internet was acting up earlier today. So we'll wait for him to come back. Wait, my phone is ringing. Why is my phone ringing? Skype audio, but it's not coming in on my... It's coming in on my phone, but not on my... All right, let's see what's happening here.
Weird, I got some sort of voicemail.
All right, are you there?
I got a British voicemail lady when I tried to call you back.
Yeah, so when you tried to call me, it rang on my phone, but not on the computer.
Weird.
Yeah, very strange. So, yeah, three of us are going to get incapped here.
Three?
That's what it's looking like. Oh, I'm sorry.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, it's not a choose for me. All right, so one of us...
Which one do we want to get incapped?
Yeah, not... so which one? I don't know. You tell me.
Probably Legacy, I think.
Could this be the birth of the Iron Legacy right here, right now?
I'm pretty sure that's how it went, right?
All right. One hero may use a power. So we could definitely knock friction out right now if we wanted to.
She's very likely to knock herself out. I think. Yeah, there's a chance she could kill us first, though, so.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm thinking, is, like, we could do something like Wraith.
Yeah, but the Wraith can do that on her own turn as well.
That's true. Or we could...
But it would be still useful to use throwing knives right now. For other reasons. The plus one damage, actually, though, it might be even better.
Yeah, that is a good point.
So, I'm going to gamble on that.
Yeah, inspiring presence surrogate.
Galvanize.
Indeed.
Oh, great. Soul diversion. Exactly what we don't want. Do you have a way to get rid of soul diversion? No.
Yes. Oh, man. Like, yeah, this one. Ugh, Ermine. The first time Ermine would be dealt damage.
Assault, then I guess I could play Lightspeed Barrage instead, actually, and take out Ermine. That's going to be what I'm going to have to do. You want to take out Absolute Zero?
I mean, Wraith is...
He has the most survivability.
Yeah, that's true. He could heal up. I mean, Wraith is going to do more damage right away, but...
What's her in cap? Draw a card, destroy an environment, put an ongoing in play on top of its deck. Actually, that would allow Tachyon to play Hypersonic Assault.
Alright, hit her.
If it gets to Tachyon's turn, which it might not. These are all a decreasing series of likelihood of things that might let us win.
So subtle diversion, I assume, would be our choice for that. All right, friction.
Oh, good. She deals herself lightning damage first.
All right. Fantastic.
All right.
Don't count us out until we're out, people.
Hypersonic Assault with a nice plus one.
Get rid of both of those horrid skunk apes. The final countdown. The final wasteland. Of course, now I get my horror fire, now when I have no ability to really use it. Although, well, I guess the math might work out. Or not.
You should. Oh, horror fire. Like, that's... That is, you need, like, it is great that you have Horrifier.
Yeah, all right, so...
Because you can choose yourself for the first damage if you, like, want to heal up, so...
All right, good, so boom. All right, choose a second.
Proletariat, probably.
Yep.
Or Ermine, I guess, but... But you can take out Proletariat, so...
Yep.
You would have been able to take out Ermine also. Actually, you should have hit Ermine with that and then use your base power for Proletariat. Though I don't know if it's going to matter, if it's any different. Or you could have used that fire to heal yourself. I don't know. And then still hit Proletariat. Just hit Ermine.
All right. Yeah. Math.
Maybe the environment will kill her.
Bygra says, oh god,
they're gonna get a new Chupacabra jersey. Takes out Tachyon. No. I want my incapability.
Alright. 6 hit points versus 25 and 3.
Hypersonic assaulted. Bad.
Ruin still does 1 damage. All right, so it's all about the incaps.
All right, do you want the plus one, or do you want to use a power straight away?
Yeah, let's see.
So if you use a power, you can destroy Ermine before she goes, and she's going to get that redirect card out.
Yeah, let's do that. I like that idea.
And then it's just you and Baron Blade.
I love this plan. I'm excited to be a part of it. All right, so here we are. 5 versus 25. Can I deal 5 damage for every damage that he does with all his other stuff? All right, so we can destroy an environment card. What's any ongoing? No ongoings in play. Who's the Chupacabra going to go after? Me. Well,
right now you.
Right now me.
But you probably won't be the lowest by the time the environment turn rolls around. Tachyon will let you draw a card, play a card, or shuffle a trash. Friction's going to destroy one of your cards as well.
Okay. So Tachyon's going to let me play potentially Horrifier.
You might just want to draw a card.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, actually. Field Freeze.
Handy.
Could be useful. I mean, I hate to lose it.
I would probably say destroy. Well, yeah, you can. You can't play one off Tachyon, can you? What do you get to do off Tachyon? Yeah, you do get to play a card. So you could destroy something that you can replace.
All right, so I can destroy my null point.
Now they can deal damage.
Hypersonic has expired. And I will play, get my null point out. And Proletariat shovels my trash, whatever.
Yeah, I think Horrifier is another good play.
Okay, so
I would heal up to get above 8, and then we'll be able to have that thing hit Empyreon instead. So you could either, I would probably just go for Baron Blade.
Yeah, I was going to say, because since I'm now at the same as him.
Well, and you're going to be another.
Oh, right, I'm going to be above.
So you could hit yourself back one. If you want to go to 11, or you could hit Baron Blade for 2 damage.
Yeah, let's hit Baron Blade. Press the advantage. All right, 18 to 9. We've taken a 5x multiplier and taken it down to a 2x multiplier. And what did I just draw? Did I just draw an onboard module?
Yeah. Not bad. That's easy for us to deal with. Actually, we can just freeze Baron Blade now with the Wraith. We can keep putting that card, which doesn't do anything until the start of his turn, back on the top of his deck. So do you want to use a power or get the plus one?
Yeah, I feel like the plus one, I'm going to be able to do more with that. Let me see what's in my hand real quick. So we got Coin Blast. Yeah, Frostbound Drain. And onboard module.
Do you think you can get Baron Blade down to the lowest to get killed?
Let's see. Ancient Library, I'm going to draw 2 and get a card played in the environment because that's just the way I roll. So I'm going to have. I don't feel like drawing a card is useful. Yeah, I don't know. What do you think?
Well, no, I wouldn't do the draw card.
No, I know, but between the other two, what do you think? Like, I would probably do the plus one at this stage.
Well, what's your plan? Frostbound Drain?
Yeah, probably Frostbound Drain. And probably deal Blade the damage and then heal myself with the fire. Like, you know, hit myself with fire and then redirect myself.
Well, depending on what the hit points are and what the environment plays. Like, yeah. You might have a chance for the environment to kill Baron Blade. So.
Well, and that's the other thing, is that's what I'm saying, is at the start of my turn, I'm going to draw two cards with the Ancient Library. So, I may have other choices. Yeah, give me the plus one.
Well, and you can use Coolant Blast on Tachyon's turn, or you could play Coolant Blast on Tachyon's turn and get...
That's true, because I have two of them, don't I?
Actually, it might be better to play...
Oh, wait, no,
Frostbound
I have...
Drain twice.
That's what I'm saying, as I have two Frostbound Drains, so...
It'd be great to be able to play both of those and use Coolant Blast. But we don't have enough. I would put that ongoing card back on top of Baron Blade's deck, so he just gets frozen playing that.
Yep. Oh, right, I forgot about this.
Oh, right, yeah, you have to... One of the things you have to do is replay one of your cards.
Yeah.
You have both of them in hand, so I don't think it matters which one.
Yeah.
And you have an onboard module you can play.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, so I think what I'll do is actually play the onboard now.
Yep.
Ugh, Sub-Zero. And get the null point out now.
Yeah, friction is keeping the tempo too slow to really build up. But yeah, Frostbound Drain makes sense. Well, unless you get a Horrifier, then that's obviously what you play.
Glacial Structure and another null point calibration. Now comes the Abominable Snowman.
With second lowest, that's probably not going to be... it might be you. We'll see.
Yeah.
Let's see. You definitely don't want to... Well, actually, you do want to get hit by the Abominable Snowman. He'll heal you for... It'll be even.
Oh, yeah.
So... Probably hit Baron Blade, I guess.
Right. Definitely down close. To one!
Definitely have to heal yourself.
Yeah. Back up to seven, though, so that's all right.
Yeah, and then hit Baron Blade, and then he'll be the second. So the snowman will hit him. Unless, like, yeah, like, it'll be just zero for you, but minus for him, so...
Thank you, environment.
The Chupacabra comes in.
Yeah, vindictively, let's remove him from the game.
Goodbye, Baron Blade.
We don't actually have the end game screen implemented yet. We will, but we did it.
Woohoo!
Three incapped heroes and Baron and Absolute Zero with seven hit points.
I did not think we were going to win that.
Indeed. So yeah, there it is, folks. That is your first look at Team Villain Mode. We played against four of the five Vengeance villains. And as you can see, so a couple of the main takeaways from like how is Vengeance Mode or Team Villain Mode... Internally, we call it Villain Team Mode. It's, you know, I think Greater Than Games calls it Vengeance Mode, or they call it Vengeance Style Villains. We call it Villain Team Mode. And basically, it's, you know, the takeaways from it are the gameplay feels like it moves a lot faster because every time the hero does something, a villain does something, which is different from the way that the normal Sentinels gameplay works. There's also a lot more to keep track of, but we think that we've built a number of really useful ideas into the UI to keep that sort of manageable. So what'd you guys think? Obviously, it's not done. We're a fair bit away from being done, but, you know,
yeah,
we wanted
to... Yeah, it's actually not into beta testing yet, but that'll be happening this week.
Woohoo!
So if you're a beta tester, watch it for that.
Indeed. All right, so should we play another game? I don't think we're going to play another team villain game.
We can play a regular mode.
Let's play a regular game. But again, we're not going to be showing off any other new content tonight, I don't think. So, I don't know. What do you guys think? Pick the villain, chat. First villain to get three votes.
And we have reserved veto.
Sure. Yeah, that's true.
We're not playing a cash Buddha, for example. Prime Wardens, eh?
Oh, look at all of those cool Vengeance heroes. I know you guys want to see them. Not tonight, sorry.
We have two votes for La Capitan.
I feel like, yeah, so that someone just requested Prime Wardens game, but we just actually played the full Prime Wardens team last week, and you guys can all play the Prime Wardens right now in the weekly one-shot, so... you don't need to watch us do it. All right, so we've got Baron Blade, Spite, Misinformation, La Capitan.
Misinformation. That's two misinformation.
Two misinformation. So we have two votes for Kargra and one for Largra. Oh, I see. It's the same person. It's Tobias. Person. Okay. Where did we play that? We played it in Final Wasteland, but you had said the block, so we're going to play in the block, whatever it might be.
Sure.
And there's the third one for La Capitan. All right. Let me find her. Boom, La Capitan. And yeah, why not? We'll go advanced. At the very least, that should hopefully make it go a little bit faster, potentially. All right, so we got La Capitan versus Prime Warden's Fanatic, Unity, Skyscraper, Corona Ranger. Got a couple heroes with self-damage happening. Should be really interesting to see at the block. Hoy niños, hand over all your valuables or get thrown overboard. Repent, turn back from thy evil ways before it is too late. All right, Prime Warden's Fanatic opens with Embolden, Holy Nova, Sanctifying Strike, Zealous Offense, Unity. For some reason I thought that you had picked Freedom 6 Unity. I guess not. Never mind. Cryobot, Hasty Augmentation, Powered Shockwave, and Turtbot. Skyscraper, Linking Incursion, Tectonic Chokeslam, Therathian Monolith, and Undetectable Relinking. And Chrono Ranger, Dead or Alive, Sudden Contract, Temporal Grenade, and Terrible Tech Strike. Out comes La Paradoja Magnifica, aka The Ship. And Siegebreaker. And of course the ship plays another one, Temporal Thief, right out of the gate. So she's gonna get four cards underneath her, which means she will flip next turn, yes?
With four heroes. Yeah, I guess it doesn't matter by age. It's three or more under, so yeah. Next turn she will, unless we have a way to destroy them, which we don't.
All right. Not enough people with stuff yet, so I'm gonna hold on to that Holy Nova, or the Embolden. All right. Not enough. Not any. Nothing in play yet. Do you want to deal one damage to the ship?
Yeah. Hit the ship. Always hit the ship.
All right. No ongoings in play, but I get to hit the ship, so that's... Yeah, look, Chrono Ranger hit the ship.
Someone in the chat says, she shouldn't have that too, she's too swingy. Maybe you should look again. Because her rating is not two anymore. Okay, should I use Hasty Augmentation to make you do 5 damage to yourself?
I would prefer not. I feel like letting Chrono Ranger do a little bit of damage would probably be a better choice, but far be it for me to tell you what to do.
Let me see. Yeah. Bit of a waste right now, but it makes sense to... get some focus damage there. And there's no equipment around, so won't use my power.
He draws a robot reclamation and skyscraper.
Perhaps a choke slam?
Yeah, I was...
Good time now when there's no bots out.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, was choke slam. I was also considering linking incursion, but I think that can hold off. We'll do choke slam for now.
Yeah, we'll be able to take out the ship. We did that. So I approve. And I can draw a bunch of cards, which may come in handy.
SonicBlade95 says, Jeremy, this isn't a tough decision. Do damage or try to be clever. We all know your choice.
How did you choke slam a boat?
I was 50 feet tall, so yeah, that's how.
You're bigger than a boat. You just find its throat, go for it.
Exactly right. Yeah, choke slam a boat, suplex a train, whatever. All right, what does the block got for us?
The time craze prisoner is very thematic with the background.
Indeed. And she flips over.
Backgrounds, you might notice there's a new background image there behind La Capitaine. We didn't talk about it too much, but in the Vengeance game, but we've added new background images for all the environments in order to support more panels in Vengeance games.
Exactly.
But those
so,
images will show up in all the games.
Yeah, so as you guys may or may not be aware, I think we've probably mentioned it in like a live stream at one point or like a listening party, but when it comes to the environment captures, excuse me, I'm yawning. It's getting late. It's been a long week. We only make as many as or the maximum that could be on screen at any given time. So 5 heroes, 1 environment, 1 villain. But now with Vengeance, we have more. Is the wrong La Capitaine graphic coming up for you as well?
Yes. She is turned to the right-hand side.
Quick, hit her while her back is turned.
I'll have a look at that.
All right. Yeah, so this is what we're talking about when we say that things are not even in beta yet. You know, Vengeance gameplay, villain team mode, is in and of itself got a lot going on, but it also can have effects on things that we have already been doing because, we're digging through a lot of code to make, add support for making sure the right thing happens at any given time. So I'm kind of thinking about final diving the time craze prisoner here.
The thing is, the time craze prisoner is not doing anything.
It's not, but that would let me do 4 damage against the beast.
Yeah, I guess if you're planning to attack the beast.
I guess I could Holy Nova.
Who was also not doing anything.
Yeah, I guess I could Holy Nova, and that would let us get a little bit of HP back and ping away one of her underneath cards. Yeah.
I'd rather that's fine. Or something else.
I'm fine with that. Sure. All right, is there... I guess I could... Well, I mean, I'm definitely going to use my power and hit myself. Actually, so here's another thing that's fun. Sacrosanct Martyr is a card with Prime Warden's Fanatic that is even more amazingly awesome than you thought it was. Because her base power does her 3 radiant damage, and then she can use another power. So if you have Sacrosanct Martyr out, and then you hit yourself for more radiant damage, that's Prime Warden's Fanatic's nuke right there. Lots and lots of damage. Yes, she has to do a lot to herself to make it happen, but whew, you can knock out a lot of stuff that way.
You just have to have Haka around to heal her with Haka Restoration.
There you go.
Yes, Dragon 3 in the chat pointed out I probably should have used no executions on the ship, but I didn't think about that. I was too greedy for cards. What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
If it comes out again, I'll do that next time. Oh, I have literally nothing useful to do. I guess I could power Shockwave and do take a chip off. I guess I'll do that. You can choose which one you want. Skyscraper is probably more useful. And there are no equipment cards in play.
Supply crate. That'll work. Okay.
So on advanced, once we do get rid of the last card, then she'll redirect.
Yeah.
What are you thinking?
I'm looking. I mean, I could Therathian Monolith and then Concussive Clap.
Yep.
And then we don't have to worry about her redirection. Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Well, and also we wanted her flip back over, so.
Yeah.
Let's see. Well, I can take out that pesky crewman. Hey, by any means, I'm gonna play that. And I may as well shoot at her. It's gonna get redirected, but that uses it up.
Yeah, so if the environment does something,
yeah,
then we'll be all right. She'll get hit, and then that'll be good stuff.
I guess we're not seeing the other version of La Capitaine. It's just that version every turn.
It's all right. Oh, well. This one is definitely the less gross one, for sure. Her flip side one, she's all, like, under the sea, kind of like, what's it called? What are those things that, carbuncles? What's the word I'm looking for? Barnacles.
Barnacles.
That's what I'm looking for.
Barnacle Bill. There's the ship again. Ooh, irreducible damage.
Wah wah.
Well, that's not bad. Actually, now, all together now, both of those copies are in the trash. So we can just destroy the ship again.
Yep.
And it won't come back.
All right. Does anybody have a second power out? No. All right.
You could put it on someone who will have a second power out.
Yes.
Like Chrono Ranger.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's do that.
It's also handy to play Zealous Offense with this Fanatic because you'll usually be dealing.
Yeah, you'll do enough damage to yourself that you'll be able to.
Actually, you aren't this turn because of Therathian Monolith.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, probably Skyscraper. Hit the ship. Hit Le Capitaine.
Pricey Province says, is Le Capitaine supposed to be facing that way? She is not.
She's just looking at the chat room.
On the live stream, the chat room is the other direction.
Yeah.
That is what's known in computer development parlance as a bug.
What?
I know, we're ruining our reputation. You guys assume that we have no bugs ever. But it does happen to the best of us.
Now I get a construction pylon.
Okay. Now I think I'm a linking incursion.
Hopefully you get some compulsion canisters.
Yeah, let's see what we get here.
Nope. Yeah, that's really good to have on Le Capitaine.
Yeah. Alright, who wants to look for equipment?
Probably yourself. And you could dig for a compulsion canister.
Yeah, that'll work.
Right now.
What do I have in my trash? All I have is a neuralizing resonator. Yeah, let's do that.
It's also not neuralizing.
What did I say?
You said neuralizing.
Neutralizing. That's like back when I used to call, not Tomoko. What's the Haka card?
Taeha.
Taeha. When I used to call it Tayana or whatever.
Tayana, yeah. I mean, neuralizer is a thing from Men in Black, so I can see where that comes from, but. Alright, I get an extra power.
I removed a letter, yes. Sorry, Lou Dolphin. I apologize. I throw myself on the mercy of the court.
I guess I should play a card that can have an extra power, but first I'm going to do a point of damage to that ship, and then another point of damage to that ship. And then my hat. And then that.
Good times.
And with the dart thrower, I'll hit Le Capitaine, I think. And you can hit. Yes. It'll be worth it. Hey, good. The block guard is disabling Siegebreaker. I'm okay with that.
Yep.
Balui asks, what has been the hardest part of programming for Vengeance? I guess there's actually been kind of two big parts to it. There's been the low-level programming that Jean-Marc has, and Jennifer have been doing the most of. And probably the main difficulties there are just sort of going through cards that deal with, the villain deck or the hero character card and that sort of thing, and having them deal with having multiple. That's probably been the main work.
Yeah, so obviously with the villain deck, that's obvious because we just showed it off because there's now multiple villain decks, but the hero character card, what John is of course referring to, is the Sentinels, which have four hero character cards in play at the beginning of the game, which we did not show off tonight, but stay tuned for future weeks because we definitely will.
Yep. And on the UI side, of course, building the different layouts to support Vengeance has been the main thing. But as anyone who has made a game or a software app would know, there are a lot of things that you need to do when you make a major change like this. Pretty much every screen in the game is affected. And so there's a lot of work that you might not think about, but goes into it. We need to destroy a card. Okay. And Mabel's coming out to...
So Bjorning says technically five cards, because I believe their setup card counts. I don't know. Is their setup card... Yeah, their setup card is not a hero character card.
No. It does not count as a card in play. It is like the Ennead card, instructions card. It's a ghost, as Christopher says.
How bad are you finding the ever-increasing field of test cases with more and more decks entering the game? Yes. Yes is the answer to that. Jean-Marc has sleepless nights.
We do have a large suite of new tests, which helps. Find regressions and stuff, but we definitely have a lot of interactions, we have a great team of alpha and beta testers who help us find lots of stuff, but I'm sure there will be bugs when Vengeance comes out.
Bella Sorcier is making fun of me for saying Bjorning. What, Bjorning? Sorry.
What's Bjorning? I don't know what you're talking about.
Bjorning. Fjords. All right. Pining for the fjords! Pining for the Bjorning.
You are AFK.
Alright. Let's see here. What's in play? We got 7, 5, 6. Ugh. No final dives, huh? Alright. Breaker.
You don't need those hit points.
I'm fanatic. There you go. I'm going to get one of them back. So I assume ship, right? Even though I can by any means serve for an extra hit point.
Yeah. We need to kill the ship and Mabel.
Oh, right, Mabel. Ah, forgot about Mabel. All right, Chrono Ranger, you want to do something?
Like one damage, not very exciting. If we have a spare equipment card, Unity could get Cryobot into play, or Turretbot into play. I think we could do that.
All right.
Yeah. I'll destroy that. Do you want to keep the link, or I can destroy the Dark Thrower?
Yeah, you can get rid of the link.
Oh, and the damage from... Lou Dolphin points out the damage from Cortex is going to redirect to Fnatic anyways.
So. There you go.
Hey, a platform bot. I would like to get that, even though it's a slight waste.
Sunk cost fallacy. I don't think it's really a sunk cost fallacy, but something wrong with using a thing to get it. Like, and that I should point out that I always succumb to that.
All right.
Like, I almost
always.
Are
you going huge?
Let me take a look. Oh yeah, I have Colossal Left Hook.
Definitely going then huge. Anything at 2 hit points is dead. So I'm going to bring Mabel down to 2 hit points.
All right, you already got rid. Oh, we haven't gotten rid of the ship, but the ship's only at 2. Okay, so we'll hit her. Yeah. Do we need to pick here, or should I just?
I don't think the order matters.
Okay.
The block guard is going to destroy one of the crew as well for us, so. And 0 for everyone. As long as they're, yeah, the non-agent with the lowest, so that's going to hit anything 3 or lower, hopefully. So Siegebreaker, I guess, would be nice. All right, what am I doing? I could get a Ranger's Mark out, get a bounty back in play. I guess I have 2 card plays. Yeah, I feel like we should try to make use of that block guard if we can. Yeah, True Shot.
Yeah, keeping ahead of True Shot is annoying, so I usually just ignore her.
Yeah, unless you have like a big one shot amount of damage or something. And yeah, I think I'm just going to focus damage on La Capitaine here.
Yeah, she's going to flip over again.
Could do more with Hunter and Hunted, but. That's okay. Yes, please. Hunter and Hunted makes Bolden very expensive.
Yes, totally.
Oh, good. Siegebreaker will be destroyed by these guys.
See ya. He's at maximum HP.
Not the Capitan. Oh, destroying all our things. I guess Embolden can go.
That's frustrating after we already paid for it, but what are you gonna do?
We must keep by any means necessary. I guess I could get it back, but it's too handy. Man.
Mm.
Well, Holy Nova is not a bad call now unless you have something better.
All right. I'm sorry, what did you say?
Holy Nova is not a bad idea now.
Yeah, that's what I was leaning towards. Yep, that's fine. Mm. right. Who wants to use a power?
Skyscraper,
yeah. Aegis of Resurrection. Fantastic.
Yeah, we can get the crew down just with sort of area damage conveniently enough for the environment to destroy them. That would be great. I guess area damage destroys them too. Yeah, I don't like Final Breath. Final Breath kills my bots. Give me back my platform bot. Can I blow up your Aegis of Resurrection?
Yeah, I got 17. Go ahead.
I've turned it into a robot.
That is a worthwhile transition.
All right, I don't think I need to hit Final Breath if you're going to stay in huge. Final Breath will get killed by the environment, and so will Lip East. Or at least they'll be hit by the block guards. Or whatever. So I'm going to target this at Le Capitaine. Yeah, if you choose the Capitaine, it's going to come back at you.
Yeah.
So I guess you may as well hit, like, Final Breath.
Yeah, that's what I was going to do. Okay, good.
Your power one will come back at you as well.
But... yeah, that one's fine. Okay, and I'm going to skip this.
Cool. How's my trash? Guess I do want Ranger's Mark. And we definitely want to leave that pieced around. So I'm going to... actually, if I use Kill on Sight, the pieced is going to die, so... I have lots of copies of Hunter and Hunted.
So many cards, whole gang, executions. Just doing my job. I gotta say, since Chrono Ranger keeps putting me in the Western motif, I'm going to once again tell everybody out there you should be watching Westworld this week. Holy cow! All kinds of stuff happened this week on Westworld you should be watching.
That is not a thing I can watch.
I know. All right. If I final dive the time craze prisoner into La Capitaine, that'll be 5 damage.
Yep.
I could also absolution, use my power on myself. And that'll be 4 damage, plus somebody else gets to use a power. What does time craze prisoner do? Let's see. At the start of the environment,
you play absolution, you don't get to... not sure what your logic is there, where you get to play absolution and give someone else a power.
Not give someone else a power, give myself a power.
You said someone else.
Oh, sorry. Oh, and I get to fight with Live again. Good times. What is Skyscraper still huge? I feel like that is the choice, unless you can put a compelling idea for it for Permaranger.
Nope, Skyscraper makes sense. I think we can focus her down pretty good here. The bots attack. I use my pylons for one bot at a time. It is how I like.
Nice. Well, there you go. You get to draw the cards with the next turn.
Could have destroyed True Shot. Don't care. I would probably just skip and do your damage.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking. Yeah, that's fine.
Sometimes you have one construction pylon and one golem and do what you gotta do. What's in my trash? Yeah, I could put a dead or alive on her. Or I could get rid of that captain's orders. That's blowing up my things. That's what I'm gonna do. A spare damage, you say? Cryobot.
Nice.
Down to 15. Lower than any of us except Fnatic.
Alright, I feel like what's his name is going to come out here. Yep, there he is.
Well, we can probably organize it so Char destroys the Capitan. He's going to do a lot of damage. 4 and 4 to every target, to every non-inmate target. So we can get it down to 8. Which I think we can. But I don't think she'll make it that far.
Yeah, I don't think so either.
She destroyed my things, and I'm sad. Oh, if you hadn't played that, Wrathful Retribution would have been the top card of your deck. You don't get to cheat.
Ah, darn it. Yeah, Skyscraper's still huge, so we'll do Skyscraper. I'd totally do that in testing. I am a dirty cheater in testing for sure.
I feel like we're missing something without our plus one anymore.
I know.
Go, go, Cryobot.
Take my Aegis. Oh, you don't have anything. Never mind. I was going to say, get another bot out, but... All right, fine, take it. Do it. Do your worst. I don't need my Aegis.
Not like it's going to the next turn anyways.
There it is, folks.
That was a good game.
That was a good game. Yeah, I like that game. All right, so you got to see tonight your first look at Vengeance/Villain Team Mode. If you came in late, check out the YouTube. This will be posted to YouTube tomorrow or Thursday, potentially, depending. But you can check it out. So you can see how Team Villain Mode is shaping up. One thing I did want to reiterate from the front of the podcast, from the front of the stream, is not to get political, but there's a lot of crazy crap happening in the United States right now. If you want to donate to any scenarios, any organizations that are helping out marginalized peoples, please do so. There's a lot of crazy stuff happening right now. And I'm doing that. Other people are doing that as well. So please, there are people who need your help. So take a look. But anyway, I think that about does it for another episode of Sentinels Live. Sentinels of the Multiverse is the only cooperative comic book card game that you should be playing. Thanks for joining us. We do this every Tuesday night at around 7 p.m. Eastern. And if you enjoy the show, please do like, share, follow, and subscribe. Sentinels is currently available on iOS, Android, and Steam, and always in good old analog cardboard and ink. And you can find more information about the game at sentinelsdigital.com. And actually, go ahead and check out sentinelsdigital.com/Prime Wardens to keep an eye on how the hunt for the Prime Wardens is going. As we mentioned again at the top of the stream, Argent Adept, Captain Cosmic, and Tempest have been discovered. The actual unlock conditions for Prime Wardens, Argent Adept, and which one? What's the other one that has been discovered? Tempest. If that is not already posted, it will be tomorrow. Have been discovered, but nobody has found Prime Wardens Fanatic or Prime Wardens Haka yet. So check it out. See if you can do it. Yeah, I think that's it. So I'm gonna say goodnight. Yeah, so. I'm Jeremy.
I'm John. Stay tuned next week for more previews, including Freight Train and perhaps some heroes.
Indeed. All right. Thanks, everybody. Have a great night. We'll see you next week.